Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we will study some assembly level language program based on the instructions which we have started in the previous videos. So let us have a look on it. Before starting with the assembly level language program, first we will see two instructions from the branching group, because without these two instructions we cannot write a program, and then the remaining instructions of the branching group we will see in the next video. So my first instruction is JMP address. JMP address means what? You have to jump onto some address unconditionally. There are two types actually. The number one is unconditional jump and number two is conditional jump. In the unconditional jump, while jumping, we don't see the condition. We don't look at the condition. We just unconditionally jump onto some address. But whereas in the second case, conditional jump, we see the condition. If the condition is getting satisfied, then only we jump onto some address. So let us see every instruction of the J conditional address one by one. Number one is JMP address. This we have already discussed. You have to jump onto some address unconditionally. In the J conditional address, the number one is JNZ address. In the JNZ address, you have to jump on not zero. Means when your Z flag is equal to zero, at that time only you will jump. Next is JZ address. Here you will jump on zero. Means when your Z is equal to 1, jump on 0 means what? Your Z is equal to 1. Jump on non-zero means what? Yes, your Z is equal to 0. So when your Z is equal to 1, then you will jump onto some address. Next is JNC address. JNC address means jump on no carry. Means if your carry is not generated, it means if your carry is 0, then you will jump onto some address. JC address is jump on carry. So if your carry is equal to 1, then only you will jump onto some address. JPO is jump on odd parity. So as we know, odd parity means what? Your parity flag sets to 0. So when your parity flag sets to 0, you will jump onto some address. JPE, jump on even parity. Even parity means obviously it will be 1. My P will be 1. So if my P is 1, then you will jump on some address. JP address is jump on plus, and JM address is jump on minus. So to check the positive and negativity of number we use, yes, we check which flag? Sign flag. So if my sign flag is equal to 0, it means my number is positive. If my sign is equal to 0, then I will jump onto some address. And if my sign is equal to 1, then obviously my number is negative. And if it is negative, then I will jump onto some address. So let us have a recap of this. JMP address, you will be jumping unconditionally. J conditional address, where you will be checking all the condition. In JNZ, jump on not zero. JZ, jump on zero. JNC, jump on no carry. JC, jump on carry. JPO, jump on odd parity. JPE, jump on even parity. JP, jump on plus, means if your S is equal to 0. And JM, jump on minus, means your S is equal to 1. Now let us start with the programs. My first program is write a program to store a block of data. Store it from memory location F050 to F057. Transfer a block of data in reverse order to another block starting with memory location F070. So in this program, what exactly we have to do is, we have a block of data from F050 to F057. We have to transfer this block of data to another block starting from F070. But while transferring it, you have to transfer a data in the reverse order. Suppose if I have a data from F0 to 50, so I am taking some random numbers. Three, five, four, five, 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 six, five, seven. Suppose if my numbers are 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8. Suppose I have this 8 numbers with me, and what I have to do is I have to transfer these 8 numbers to the another block starting from F070. So it will be F070, 71. Okay, so I have to transfer these numbers of F050 to F057, but in the reverse order. So let us start with the program. The first is MVIC08. So what I did is, how many numbers I have here? 8 numbers. So my counter will be 8, and that counter I have stored inside the register C. So my C is equal to 08. LXI H F050. Now see, to store a data in the register, to store a data in F050, I need some register pair, since F050 is memory location, and which is of how many bytes? Yes, it is of 2 bytes, so it can't go inside the single register, so I have taken what register pair for it. So for F050 I have taken HL pair, and for F077 I have taken DE pair. Now see, I initialized HL pair with the F050, but I initialized my DE pair, since it is D, obviously with D you will be having E. So I have initialized my DE with F077. Now why it is so? Because I will be transferring my data in the reverse order. So obviously my F050 will go inside F077, not inside F070. It will go inside F077. So I have initialized my LXI D, means my DE pair, with F077. Now the next step is move A comma M. Now as we all know, MEM stands for memory. Memory points to HL pair. So you are transferring the data of memory to the accumulator. Currently memory is pointing to HL pair, and HL pair is at F050. So in the F050, I have a number called as 01. So that number will go inside the accumulator. So now my accumulator will be 01. STXD, you're transferring your data from accumulator to DE pair. Now see, what is my DE pair? Yes, it is F077. So the data from F050 was 01. Went inside F077. So here I transferred my first number in the reverse. Now to go to the next memory location, I have to jump onto the F051, and to jump onto the F051, I have to increment my HL pair by 1. So I wrote INXH. Now again here I have to jump onto F076. Since I am decrementing the register pair by 1, I have used here DCXD. I have transferred one number. Now how many numbers are left? 7 numbers are left. So I need to decrement my counter as well. So my counter is equal to DCRC. So my counter will get decremented and it will become 7. JNZ back. Now this we have already studied. Now JNZ means what? Jump to not 0. Jump to not 0 means what? If Z is equal to 0, then you will be jumping. When your Z is equal to 0, if your result of arithmetic and logical operation will be non-0, then it will be 0. So what I have to do is, I got my counter as 7. It is not 0. So again, I have to jump back. When my counter will become 0, my Z flag will set. So, but now my counter is not 0, my Z flag is reset, and if it is reset, then I have to jump back. So again what I will do, I will take a number from memory and I will transfer that number inside the accumulator. So in the next iteration, your 02 will go inside the accumulator. STXD, from accumulator it will go to D. So see, in F076 I got 02. Again need to increment H, so I will go to F052. Again I need to decrement D, so I will go to F075. I have transferred 2 numbers, so how many numbers are left? 6 numbers are left, so again I will decrement my counter. At this time my counter ka value will be 6. It is not 0, so again I will go back. So I will keep on repeating this process till my counter becomes 0. We'll see one more iteration. Again I will take next number, move A comma M means what? I will again take my next number, that is 03, inside the accumulator. From 03, from accumulator, it will go to D. So it will come here. Again, I will increment my HL pair. So I will go to F053. I will decrement my DE pair. So I will go to F074. You decrement your counter. Again, your counter is not 0. Again, you go back. So you have to keep on repeating this process till my counter becomes 0. Once it is 0, you will come out of the loop and you will get all numbers transferred in the another block, but in the reverse order. Write a program that subtracts numbers stored in F051 from numbers stored in F050. Store the absolute difference in F052. Now in this case, we have to perform subtraction of two numbers. Now they have given me two memory locations, that is F050 and F051, and the answer will get stored inside F052. Now what we have to do, we have to subtract a number stored in F051 from the number stored in F050. So suppose if this is 3, this is 5, obviously it is going to be a 2. Okay, so we'll see how the execution of this program will happen. Alexa HF050, first I have taken one memory HL pair and I have initialized that HL pair with the memory location F050. So in the F050, I took a number 03. Next is move A, M. Move A, M means the number which is there in the memory that will go inside the accumulator. In HL pair, I have a number 03, so that 03 will go inside the accumulator. So now my accumulator, I'm writing here, my accumulator is equal to 03. Next is INXH. INXH means you will increment your HL pair, so you will go to F051. Next is subtract memory from accumulator. So you have to subtract the number which is there in your memory. Now what is there in the memory? I have come on F051. So I have come on F051, and in the F051 I have a data 05. So what I will do? I will subtract my 05 from the accumulator. So if I will subtract 05 from the accumulator, your answer is going to be what? 2. Now in this case, we check whether I'm getting the answer as a positive answer or I'm getting the answer as a negative answer, since you are storing the absolute difference in the F052. If you are getting the answer as a positive answer, then directly you will store that answer in F052. But in case if you are getting answer as a negative answer, suppose if I'm subtracting 3 minus 5, so in that case my answer is going to be a minus 2. So if you're getting answer as a negative answer, so what we do, we just once complement of that number and again we store that number inside the memory location. Means if you are getting the answer as a negative answer, then just perform once complement of that number, you will get a positive answer. So now see, in this case it is 5 minus 3, so it will be 2. So what I will see, I will do here JP next. JP means what? Jump on plus. So jump on plus, I will check which flag? Yes, I will check sign flag. If my sign flag is 0, then I will directly jump on to INXH, means I will go to F052, and the answer I have got in the accumulator is 2, that will go inside the memory. But in case, as I said, if my answer is negative, if my sign flag is 1, then what I will do, I will complement my number. I will complement my number and I will add 1s into that number. So I called it as 1s complement. So I will make a 1s complement of that number so that my answer will be a positive, and then I will store that answer inside the memory location. So this is how I perform subtraction of two number. First, what I did, I took a number in F050. I moved that number inside the accumulator. I went inside the next memory location. In the next memory location, I have another number, that is 05. Then what I did, I subtracted from my memory from the accumulator. So when I subtracted my memory from the accumulator, 5 minus 3 is going to be a 2. I directly stored my answer inside the memory location F052 because my answer was positive. But if it is negative, then again do a complement of that number, add 1 into that number, and then store that answer inside the respective memory location. Because if you are getting answer as negative, we do the 1's complement of the number and we convert that answer into a positive answer, and then we store that number. So this is how we perform subtraction of two numbers. I hope you have understood both the programs which I wrote using those instructions. In the first program, I transferred my data from one block to another block, and in this block I performed the subtraction of two numbers. Thanks for watching this video.